Hello, good morning everybody. In this video, we are going to make the transition to the game scene. But first, I would like to fix a bug with the last video. If there are other clients connected in addition to the creator, and the creator disconnects, the other clients will still be connected. But they cannot start the game. So, it does not make sense to keep them connected. Let's kick them off. In the server project, go to the player disconnected function. Inside the else at the end, add an if that checks if the removed player is the creator. If it is, iterate over the player's interrupt and kick them out using the disconnect peer function of the network peer. If the disconnected player is not the creator, execute the other for loop, the one that calls the remove player function of the client. Now, go to the client project and call the stop function in the server disconnected function. This is the function that will be called when we kick out the players. Calling a stop, we remove all the players and we disconnect the network signals. If the creator client disconnects now, all the other clients of the room will disconnect too. But we get an error. The error suggests to connect the signals using connect the ferret. So that's what we are going to do. Scroll up to the part where we connect the signals. Between the flags and the method name, there is an argument to pass extra arguments to the function. We don't want to pass any extra arguments, so use an empty array. Pass connect the ferret as the last argument. This flag emits the signal on either frames, so the signal won't be emitted when we remove the network peer and we won't get the error anymore. If we try to disconnect the creator client again, this time we don't get any error. Now, it's time to make the transition to the game scene. In the client script, create a function called startGame. Call the startGame function of the server. We want to call this function when the creator clicks the OK button. So connect the confirmed signal of the create dialog to the menu script. Inside the function, call the startGame function of the client. When the creator client presses the button, the startGame function of the server will be called. Let's make that function. Open the server project and create the startGame function. The function will be called remotely, so don't forget to add remote at the start. Get the ID of the player who called the function using the getRPCSenderID function. Now, we need the room to access the rest of the players in it. Let's make a simple function to get the room. Create a new function with the name getRoom, with a parameter that contains the ID of a player. Return the room where the player is. We can get the room ID using the ID of the player as the key in the player's room dictionary. Use the room ID we obtained to access the room of the room's dictionary. The function returns a dictionary with the information of the room. The player's array, the creator ID. Back at the startGame function, get the room using the function we just created. Since the game started, change the state of the room to started. Iterate over all the players in the room and call the preconfigureGame function of each player. Go back to the client project. Add the preconfigureGame function in the client script. Here is where we will change the send and spawn the other players. First of all, pause the game. We will resume it when all the players are ready to start. Next, KW3, the current scene, the menu. Store the game scene in a variable. Load the scene with the preload function and create a new instance with the instance function. Add the game as a child of the root node and set the current scene to the game scene. Why not change the scene using the changeScene function? Well, changeScene does not stop the function execution. So, after calling it, the following code will still see the menu as the current scene. Changing the scene manually, we make sure the current scene is the game scene before continuing with the rest of the function. After that, spawn the player of the client. Store a new instance of the player scene in a variable called myPlayer. Add the player as a child of the game scene and assign it to the instance of the player info that has his ID. To spawn the other players, iterate over the information in the player info dictionary. We already spawned the player of the client, so don't spawn it again. Add an if to make sure the ID is different than the client ID. As before, create a new instance of the player and store it in a variable. But this time, use the base character scene instead of the player scene, since the other players won't be controlled by this client. We don't need all the functionality of the player scene, only the basics. Add the player in the game scene and change the instance of player info that references the player. Finally, at the end of the function, call the down preconfiguring function of the server. We tell the server the client has finished loading the game. Go back to the server project and add the down preconfiguring function. First of all, get the ID of the player who called the function. With this ID, get the room of the player. Increase the player's down of the room by 1. Check if all the players are down, comparing the player down with the size of the player's dictionary. If they are, iterate over all the players and call the down preconfiguring function of each one. Go to the client and create the down preconfiguring function. Inside the function, unpause the game. This function will be called when all the players are ready. At this moment, the game will start. Let's try it. If we try to start the game, nothing happens. In the output, we can see a message saying that the client disconnected from the server. That's the print I put in the server disconnected function. We also get an error because we tried to use RPC ID when we are not connected. The problem is that we stop the server when a pop-up window is closed. When we change the scene, even if we do not close the windows ourselves, the pop-up height signal is emitted anyway. To fix it, create a boolean variable called gameStarted and initialize it to false. Go to the onPopUpHeight function and make sure this variable is false before stopping the connection. The stop function will only be called when gameStarted is false. Now, we need a way to set gameStarted to true when the OK button is pressed. At the start of the preconfigure game function, change gameStarted to true using the setDeferred function. I tried changing the variable in the function called when the confirmed signal is emitted, but it does not work. That's the only way I found to change the variable to true before the pop-up height signal is emitted. If we play the game now, the result will be the same as before. That's because we have to set height on OK of the create dialog to false. The window hides anyway, but it seems now the above height signal is emitted after game started is changed to true. If we try to start the game again, we will see that it switches the scenes without problems now. We can move our player around the ship, but it does not yet synchronize it with the other clients yet. We will implement that in the future. Everything seems fine, except for a player standing at the corner. If we close one client, the game crashes. Let's take a look at the remote view. There are 4 players when there should be only 2. The problem is that we still have the 2 players we added in the game scene to test the movement in a previous video. Since the players are now spawned with the client script, we can remove these 2 players. There are not extra players now. There is still the player in the corner, but that's the player of the other client. It will move in the future. If we check the remote view, we can see that there are only 2 players this time. When I closed one client, the other clashed. That's because the remove player function only works for the menu scene. Next, we are going to modify it to remove players from the game too. In the remove player function, add an if that checks if the name of the current scene is menu. If it is, execute the remove player function of the menu. Otherwise, we are in the game scene. To remove a player from the game scene, we can simply keyframe his instance we have stored in the player info array. This will remove the player from the sentry. Let's do the same for the remove all players function. If we are in the menu scene, call the remove all players of the menu script. If we are in the game scene, iterate over all the players in the player info dictionary and keyframe them all. If you play the game now, when we close a client, the game does not crash. And the player in the corner, the player of the client who disconnected, is removed. I made an image to summarize all the calls we made to start the game. Take a look. The game is starting to take shape. In the next video, we will make the players synchronize their position between all the clients. I hope you liked the video, and see you in the next one.